When healing wounds, it's important to choose the correct materials for the job. Let's talk about how to select the best wound dressings for you. In this video, we're going to go over what wound dressings are and how you can select the best one for your application. So a wound dressing is a covering that covers the wound, sticks to skin with tape or glue. Wound dressings come in different forms. Those include gels, foams, and gauze. Wound dressings prevent infection, aid healing, and reduce pain. There are many kinds of wound dressings for all different applications. We've put together a list of the 9 main kinds. Let's go over the pros and cons of each. First are gauze bandages. The advantages of gauze bandages are that they are versatile and can be cut to size. They're cost-effective and readily available most anywhere first aid supplies are sold. The disadvantages are that they do not stick well to the skin or wounds, cannot hold fluids, and may fall off, potentially causing irritation and pain. Second is hydrocolloid bandages. The advantages are hydrocolloid bandages create a seal over wounds, preventing dirt from entering and promoting natural healing. They can also prevent fluid leakage, reduce pain and swelling. The disadvantages are that they are not suitable for deep or infected wounds, may come loose, and can be challenging to remove. Third is hydrogel wound dressings. The pros are hydrogel bandages adhere well, cover wounds comfortably, and can withstand frequent changes. They seal wounds, slow bleeding, and prevent deep tissue infection. The cons are that they are thick and one use, they may be uncomfortable and require careful application. Fourth is moisture retention bandages. The advantages are that these dressings absorb drainage, reducing infection risk and pain, and they promote tissue growth. The disadvantages are that they may fall off, do not allow wounds to breathe, and pose a risk of further contamination. Fifth is oxygen absorbing bandages. The pros of these bandages are increased oxygen levels for faster cell regeneration and healing. They also help seal wounds, keeping bacteria out. The disadvantages are they cannot remove liquid and are not suitable for deep or infected wounds. Sixth is sterile gauze bandages. Advantages of these, sterile gauze bandages adhere well, allow wounds to breathe, and come in various shapes and sizes. The disadvantages are that they do not control bleeding or infection effectively and may need frequent reapplication. Seventh is transparent film bandages. The pros are that they are cost-effective, easy to apply, and allow wounds to breathe. They're only suitable for one-time use. The cons are that they don't absorb well, may slow healing for deeper infected wounds, and have a tendency to fall off. Eighth is tissue adhesive bandages. The advantages are they provide a tight seal, reduce pain, and promote tissue growth. The disadvantages are that they do not support natural healing, may cause blisters, and require regular reapplication. Lastly, we have wound dressing foam. The advantages of these are that they promote faster natural healing, seal wounds effectively, reduce bacterial growth, and are suitable for soft tissue wounds. The disadvantages are that they don't adhere well to dry wound surfaces, and may contain latex, which can trigger allergies. The way you can find a wound dressing that works best for you is working with your converter, who has experience with many different types of wound dressings. Every wound dressing has pros and cons when it comes to medical treatments. Thus, most professionals have specific products for specific wounds. If you have any more questions, make sure you check out our Learning Center on our website or reach out to us directly. Thanks for watching.